Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1983. Today, we're going to talk about Return of the Jedi. Return of the Jedi is the third film in the Star Wars franchise. If you have not seen the original Star Wars film or The Empire Strikes Back and do not want their plot spoiled, there will not be much for you in this video, and I would recommend not watching. Thank you for your interest, and I hope to see you in the next video. The story of Return of the Jedi takes us back to George Lucas. We of course talked about George Lucas in our videos on Star Wars and The Empire Strikes Back. While The Empire Strikes Back might not have been as successful as some of the creators had hoped, the film was successful, and work began quickly on a sequel. George Lucas, wanting to keep his film independent of the major studios, personally financed much of the production of Return of the Jedi, much as he had tried to do with the previous films. Because he assumed this responsibility, Lucas felt that hiring a separate director would be best for this film. Lucas's first choice was his friend Steven Spielberg. We have talked about Steven Spielberg before. He directed Raiders of the Lost Ark and E.T. the Extraterrestrial. However, due to a dispute between George Lucas and the Directors Guild, Spielberg could not direct the film. Lucas also considered David Lynch, David Cronenberg, and Lamont Johnson to be the director, but ultimately Richard Marquand was chosen. Richard Marquand was coming off the critically acclaimed British spy film, The Eye of the Needle. To help write the script, Lucas hired Lawrence Kasdan, who had also written The Empire Strikes Back and Raiders of the Lost Ark. The screenplay for the film would be finished late into pre-production, after a budget and production schedule had already been set. For the actual shooting script, Kasdan, Lucas, Marquand, and producer Howard Kazanjian would record meetings together, and Kasdan would construct a script based on those tapes. Most of the cast from the earlier films had signed contracts to be in the second sequel to Star Wars. However, Harrison Ford, who plays Han Solo, had not. This is seen as a major reason for the character's uncertain fate at the end of The Empire Strikes Back. With the success of Raiders of the Lost Ark, it was uncertain whether Ford would be interested in another Star Wars film. Producer Howard Kazanjian was responsible for negotiating a deal to get Ford to join the rest of the cast. Filming began on January 11, 1982. Through a few issues and frustrations between the cast and crew, filming was completed on May 20, 1982. This was a schedule a full 6 weeks shorter than the filming of The Empire Strikes Back. The idea was to give George Lucas's special effects company, Industrial Light and Magic, the most time possible to complete their work. Because much of the funding and much of the production was done by George Lucas and his companies, the film operated on a relatively low budget of just $32.5 million, over $94.6 million in 2022. John Williams returned to compose and score the film. We have talked about John Williams before. Among many others, John Williams' film scores we have previously talked about include Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, Raiders of the Lost Ark, and E.T. the Extraterrestrial. Industrial Light and Magic was responsible for most of the film's special effects. Feeling the pressure to outdo the first two films, ILM was pushed to their limits to make this film. It is said the company operated 20 hours a day, 6 days a week, but they were able to meet their deadline of April 1st, 1983. When George Lucas began testing the film in commercial theaters, he came across issues with the audio quality. He found that the quality of the sound systems in the theaters were outdated and unable to give the moviegoer an adequate experience. In particular, the soundtrack of the film could not be heard in several scenes. This led Lucas to create a new company named THX. THX would create an audio quality standard that movie theaters would meet to ensure a good experience. When the film was first being advertised, the teaser trailer showed the name as Revenge of the Jedi. While this was, for a time, seen as a better title for the film, George Lucas ultimately decided that Jedi would not seek revenge, so the name returned to its original title, Return of the Jedi. Return of the Jedi was released on May 25th, 1983. The release was moved up 2 days in order to coincide with the release of the original Star Wars film. It proved to be successful very quickly. In its first week, Return of the Jedi grossed a record $45.3 million, over $127.8 million in 2022. In total, the film would gross over $475 million worldwide. The film proved to be quite a success. Critics at the time had mixed opinions of the film. While the film's special effects and sound were generally praised, the acting and story were typically seen as some of the film's weaker aspects. The film proved to be divisive, with some critics saying that this was the best installment of the franchise, while others claimed it was the worst. The film would be accompanied by several other works. The film would have a novelization written by James Caan. Marvel Comics would publish several comic books to tie in with the release of the film. The film also had a book and record set that would give the reader an abridged version of the story. And of course, there was plenty of merchandise. It is said that many story decisions were made due to the impact the plot points would have on merchandise sales, which would put merchandising as a high priority during filmmaking. That is the backstory to Return of the Jedi. With that now told, it's time to talk about the plot of the film. If you have not seen the film and do not want its plot spoiled, now would be the time to stop watching. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. For those that have stayed, let's talk about the plot of Return of the Jedi. Return of the Jedi takes place a year after Han Solo was captured. The droids C-3PO and R2-D2 are sent to Jabba the Hutt's palace on Tatooine to negotiate for Han's release. Princess Leia, disguised as a bounty hunter, brings Chewbacca, and the two try to free Han, unfreezing him from the carbonite, but they are captured. Luke arrives to try and negotiate for his friend's release, but Jabba drops Luke through a trap door. Luke fights a rancor in order to escape. Jabba then sentences Luke, Han, and Chewbacca to be fed to the Sarlacc in the desert. Luke is able to free himself and his friends. In the ensuing fight, the bounty hunter Boba Fett falls into the Sarlacc, and Leia strangles Jabba the Hutt to death. After the escape, Luke returns to Dagobah to complete his training with Yoda. Yoda, while on his deathbed, confirms that Darth Vader is Luke's father, but also tells Luke that there is another Skywalker. He then dies and becomes one with the Force. Obi-Wan's spirit appears and tells Luke that Leia is actually his twin sister. He also tells Luke that he must defeat Vader and the Empire in order to complete his training. The Alliance discovers that the Empire is building a second Death Star. The station, while under construction, is being protected by an energy shield. The generator of this shield is on the forest moon of Endor. So, Han Solo leads a small team, including most of our heroes, down to Endor in order to destroy the generator, allowing the Rebel fleet to destroy the new Death Star. On Endor, the team encounters a tribe of Ewoks, and, after some initial difficulties, the two groups gain each other's trust. It is there that Luke tells Leia that she is his sister, and that Darth Vader is their father. Luke is willingly captured so that he can go see Vader and try to convince him to abandon the dark side of the Force. Vader rejects Luke's plea and takes Luke to the Emperor. The Emperor tries to turn Luke to the dark side of the Force, telling Luke that the rebels have fallen for a trap. Meanwhile, on Endor, Han's team is captured by the Empire. Luckily, the Ewoks are able to assist, and the rebels are able to get inside the generator. Lando Calrissian and Admiral Akbar lead the assault on the second Death Star. but the shield is still active, and the Empire is waiting for them. The Emperor explains to Luke that the Death Star is fully operational and orders it to fire, destroying a rebel starship. Luke attempts to attack the Emperor, but Vader stops him and the two fight in a lightsaber duel. Vader senses that Luke has a sister and threatens to turn her to the dark side. This angers Luke, who defeats Vader in the duel, severing Vader's hand. The Emperor tries to get Luke to take Vader's place, but Luke refuses. The Emperor tortures Luke with Force lightning. Vader, seeing his son in pain, then turns on the Emperor and throws him down a reactor shaft. Vader, though, is electrocuted in the process. Dying, Vader asks Luke to remove his mask. Luke does so, forgiving his father, and Vader dies in Luke's arms. The team on Endor destroys the shield generator. Lando leads a group of fighters into the Death Star's core. The rest of the fleet destroys an Imperial command ship while the Death Star's core is destroyed and Luke escapes on a shuttle. Back on Endor, the heroes celebrate. Luke burns Vader's armor on a pyre. As everyone celebrates, Luke is visited by the Force ghosts of Obi-Wan, Yoda, and his father, Anakin Skywalker. That is the plot of Return of the Jedi. Return of the Jedi would prove to be influential, not only in the world of film, but also in the world of video games. We will continue to hear about Return of the Jedi as we move forward. While Return of the Jedi is the end of the trilogy of Star Wars films, this would not be the final story that takes place in the Star Wars universe. This would not be the final film in the franchise either. We will revisit the Star Wars universe in the future. As for the people behind the film, they would all continue to work in the industry. We will hear from most of these creators again in the future as well, especially George Lucas, Harrison Ford, and Mark Hamill. That will do it for the story of Return of the Jedi for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we clean up the streets.